Monday Sneakerheads back with another great episode. Johnny J's here with Bernita, the owner-operator of 23 Sneaker Lounge here in Covington, Kentucky on Madison Avenue. Beautiful atmosphere, great spot that you hit next to the Madison Theater for those in the city that are familiar with the area. Please tell me on how you started your business and got off into exactly sneakers and Jordans.
Well, I started this business about 9 years ago. I started it for my son. I noticed that there were a lot of African Americans that wouldn't start businesses for their kids and put them in position. So I started that in mind and thinking that if I grew the business for him, within 9 to 10 years, he'd be able to take over the business and be successful as a black young man in the community.
Oh man, what a great, great thing you have done in a beautiful spot that you guys have down here. To jump off into sneakers and the rapid growth over the last 10 years, a great idea that you came up with here on your son. Yes, before we go any further, I want to make sure we let everybody know what we're rocking on feet today. Let them know what you're rocking today.
I'm rocking these Breads. Personally, this is my favorite pair of shoes. I had them when I was a teenager and always wanted a fresh pair.
Everybody waiting on that one to come out for Christmas. I know I'm waiting on it. That's a classic shoe. But do you prefer, let me ask you this, the high cut or the low cut pack level?
I prefer the high cut for ankle stability. It's a real clean shoe. The patent leather is perfectly displayed on this shoe. And the red bottoms are significant to me.
Right, that's first. That was the first we've seen a red bottom on a gym shoe when they did that one, and everybody was crazy for it. Today, as usual, I'm rocking the black, what they call these, the Royals, the black and gold, the Royal Fours. Another great four for another great episode. Let me know where your passion started from when you got into the sneaker game. Where did you really start? We've seen different things on your Instagram and the tons and tons of heat that you hold, and how did you really get started in the game?
Well, my passion started with the shoes. As a teenager, I always wanted, or it was always great to be able to get a pair of Jordans. My parents always made sure I kept a pair. I always got the shoes that I wanted. When I went on into my career in the military, a lot of people wanted trophies, so therefore we always talked about Jordans and we purchased Jordans. Throughout the years, I started trading Jordans or selling Jordans. My son is a real big sneaker freak, so I named him Jordan. So the name just stuck with us, and I knew that it was a lucrative business. And a lot of African Americans don't follow that. When I know that you can make millions buying and selling shoes and flipping shoes, it was easy for me to understand that that's the field that we wanted to go into.
Being a female in the game and out here at these sneaker events with so many males buying and selling the shoes, they try to play you on your knowledge on certain sneakers and being in this game?
Most definitely. But I know that knowledge is power. I spend a lot of time reading and educating myself on shoes, release dates, the market, all the information that is possible for me to be better in the business. As a female, I try not to let my gender precede me in any transaction that I do with these people in the sneaker game. Most of them are younger than me, so therefore I have a little leverage or an advantage in the game.
Right.
Like I told you earlier, I'm working on my master's degree in business. So as long as you're educating yourself and you're doing what you need to do to be a better business person, it doesn't matter about your gender nor your age.
I can really dig that. I can dig that. And when I seen you on Instagram, and I was telling you when I came in, I noticed it was a female from the shoes you were holding, and I knew that you would be knowledgeable in this game, and I really needed to add this to my channel. And what you started here is a beautiful thing. I wanted to salute you on that.
Well, my tag on Instagram, normally I just show the shoes. I don't display myself. I use my nails to point or simulate that it is a female behind the game. Therefore, everyone hopefully knows that it's a female, but I never posted pictures of myself.
We want to get into some of the heat that she has here in the store. We picked these Nike Adapts. I don't feel like a lot of people know about them. I'm going to let her speak on them, and we'll show the shoe and let you all get a little knowledge of what we got here in the shop. So the Nike Adapt, tell me about this one.
The The Nike Adapt was released May 2019. This is pretty much a shoe designed for basketball. It comes with solar packaging so that it could charge the charger. It also comes with a charging board.
So you put that USB cord, that board actually charges the shoe.
Yes.
Yeah.
When the shoe needs recharging, you just place the shoes here as such, and you plug them in and charge them.
So this is Nike's Back to the Future shoe. It's a self-lacing system, so you have to charge it up to be able to operate the shoe. And I believe it's got a light system on the side as well. This is a really dope shoe. The price is pretty steep, but I don't know if resale. I think resale has risen, got kind of outrageous. I don't know, outrageous in my pockets, but for her to have this in the shop, we definitely had to get this one.
You know we had to get a four in here. One of my favorites, but it's out of my price range at this point. Let's talk about this Jordan Levi, the black one, the black four.
This Jordan Levi 4 was released June 30th, 2018. It released with the white pair and after the blue jean denim pair that was released. This is a tag pair of Levi 4s.
This shoe is definitely one that I need to get in my collection, but my pockets won't allow. I'm a crazy, crazy fan of Jordan 4s. This one is so hot. How was it getting your hands on this shoe? I know it was tough. Did they sold out so fast? What was the market around it when you had to get your hands on it?
When these shoes released, they released for $220. At that time, I didn't purchase them. I didn't know how the craze would go with this shoe, but they're still fashionable. They're still great, and the resale value is still up.
Let's get into these Jordan 9s. Another hot shoe that they came out with. This one, they showed a picture of it, and I think it released like so fast, right a week or so after they introduced it. What was the release date on this?
The release date on this shoe was April 2018. Mm-hmm. Resale value or retail was $190, $220.
I think it was to commemorate Carmelo's championship at Syracuse University. Dope shoe with the gold on the bottom. Was that one might scare you a little bit if you get a lot of wear out of it and that gold begin to chip off and flake. So, and you know, with these rappers and everybody with their gold teeth, you got gold on the bottom of your shoe. I don't think it was enough for everybody to go around and get these. I was upset, wish I had a pair, but she got them here in her shop. Holla at her. Another shoe that I seen here in the shop and picked it up, but this one is not for sale, but I had to get it on camera for our show, Everyday Sneakerheads. One of the more popular collabs, it just with Nike and Off-White. This one was released
in May of 2018.
I mean, everything that Off-White is touching with Nike is on fire. The ticket on these is ridiculous. My man Jordan in the background, want me to say it again, this one is not for sale. This is a personal pair of his own. But I just had to get it on camera and let you guys see what they did with this shoe. All the Off-White is off the chain. Looking around her shop, I had to get some of her merchandise, some real dope tees that she has with the brand on it. Let's go over a few colorways. I'm really in love with this yellow one, but we'll start with this blue one, the one that she's rocking today too. Tell me a little bit about how y'all picked the color for this one. I mean, that's just a dope colorway the way y'all did that.
This turquoise t-shirt, we picked the color pretty much for a spring and summer attire. We also wanted to be able to advertise with multicolors, so the different colorways are symbolic, and to put Covington on the map to let them know that we have sneakerheads in Covington. We have this canary yellow 2-3 Sneaker Lounge shirt available, and we also went with the red and black with the basketball shape here. Letting you know that it was established in 2018 and we're located in Covington, Kentucky.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with the red. If you're rocking your J's, everybody has their reds. Can't say enough about red and how much we all love it. Dope t-shirt. To talk about another accessory that she has here in her store that every sneakerhead, true sneakerhead, has seen before, I seen this one and had to get it on camera. It was a must. The sneaker box that she has. This one is a Kyrie sneaker box. You always see the Jordan box, but to see this one with Kyrie and Uncle Drew under the bottom, tell me a little bit about this one.
This sneaker box I got from Kids Kicks, shout out to Kids Kicks, at a sneaker event in Indianapolis, Indiana. He gave me the idea that not only is it good to just sell sneakers, I told him that I went on with apparel, and so we also added the sneaker box. This featured box is a Kyrie Irving box with Uncle Drew here, Don't Reach Young Blood. We have the Kyrie's here, and since they're see-through, we also have the socks that go with it. All of this is available here at 23 Sneaker Lounge.
How many sneakers can you get in here out of the box? How many
These pair? Boxes hold 16 pair up to size 14 comfortably. This is where you can display your trophies, you can display your collection, and always have something to store them comfortably within your home.
So what's the price on one of these? I know you guys have different styles. You could get Jordan on them as well. What's the price for one of these?
This particular box, the Kyrie Irving, is going for $400. I also have the Jordan Cement box, which is $350.
That's the classic.
And I have a Supreme, which is $450 with more details.
Dope box. Everybody been trying to get those. I'm thinking about making a purchase on one of those myself.
These boxes are great for any kid going off to college, going back to school. A great conversation piece for the dorm rooms, yeah, and a place to store your shoes away from everything else, yeah, in your room.
That's always a tug of war, having so many pairs of shoes and where you put them. Being that you're walking on the floor with them, always good to put them away from everything, germs and everything else that comes with wearing so many sneakers. Let's go over some of this heat that she has on the wall. We'll just give you a little taste of what you'll see when you come over here to her store. Picking up some heat right off the bat, this Jordan 6, what was your opinion on this one when it came out? One I still don't have in my collection, but that Gatorade 6, what'd you think about that one?
Well, I have this shoe in my collection. This was a must have. This Gatorade has been with Nike and Jordan for a long time. This is something that is always advertised during the games. I think that this is a nice shoe. Not only did I get the shoe, I got the t-shirt, the jacket, and the towel that comes in the box, which is a must have.
This is a real dope collab that they did. I got the orange and white one that they also did, similar to the Carmine. They flipped the red and put the orange on it, but this one was out there, didn't get my hands on it, fell through on the day of the release date, just haven't went back and gotten it, but real dope shoe. Let's move on to this sweater Jordan that they came out with. What was your opinion on this? I said it before, I'm not a fan of some of the nylon they do on Jordans with that high price, but this one was a dope concept. What did you think about that one?
I really dig the Retro 6. I have a lot of these in my collection. This is the shoe that Michael Jordan wore on Saturday Night Live. Yeah. This is known as the Flight Jacket. Real clean shoe. I like it. It's a rare shoe, and to me, it was a must-have.
Yeah, it was like a quilted jacket he had on, and they tried to implement that into the shoe, called them the Flight Jacket. Yeah. Now, people might not have seen this one too much. This was an overseas release, I believe they call it.
This shoe is a Chinese Single Day.
Okay, Single Day.
Retro 13. There was two colorways that this shoe released in. This red was released for the males, and the teal color was released for the females.
I couldn't remember what color that was. It was a teal.
Yeah. On this day in China, if you were single, you were to rock the shoes. The males, like I said, in red. The females were in the teal color, and that was their mating or dating process.
You're always going to learn here something here at Everyday Sneakerheads. I don't think a lot of people knew that. Just seeing this red on this shoe was fire. They tricked us. Before they said it was Single Days, they showed us this shoe, and I was going to put in some footwork and get it, but once they said Single Days, I knew it was a wrap.
This shoe also has another feature to it. Right here where the black is displayed, you can rub this off, and it will display pandas underneath where this black is on the shoe.
Yeah, real dope shoe. One that's also out there I wanted to speak on, and if you're into this Jordan stuff like we are, the market on this shoe, the value has went up in the market here recently. A hot shoe that they did with a neutral gray. What did you think about this one with that fire orange they got on there?
I really wasn't feeling this shoe. I didn't think that it would do very well in the resale game.
Yeah,
but
it's set.
The shoes were trending. There's been a series or a lot of shoes that's been released this year with this different address of the retro high.
Yeah.
The resale on some shoes went crazy. So if you're a reseller, you got to get what your customers like.
Right.
So that's why I chose these shoes.
Yeah, I thought it was some real good quality that they put on this shoe. Something different made it like a rugged look. But one I wasn't a fan of until I also seen it on feet was this six. Everybody thinks it's black, but this is actually a navy blue on there. That shoe sat around for a while, but I began to see people wear it and it kind of grew on me a little bit. What did you think?
Right, I think it's a nice shoe. It is still sitting in the mall. A lot of resellers, we bought the shoes, but it's still sitting. But for someone that needs this colorway and still wants to rock the Jordan, I see no problem with picking this up and rocking.
Yeah, as we go down the wall here, I wanted to go over some of the bags. I also have some book bags. Tell me a little bit about this brand. I know bags is going crazy out there with back to school, and the gym shoe kids, sneakerheads, love their book bags. Tell me a little bit about these.
I'm an authorized spray ground reseller. This bag is the Money Drip bag. This is the Keep Hustling. This is the Diablo Returns. And this is the NBA Youngboy featured bag with spray ground. Great for back to school for kids going off to college and high school.
Dope bags. Had to make sure I mentioned them. This iced out panda, this bear, had to get that one on camera.
It also has the 38 baby tag here, symbolizing that this is an NBA Youngboy bag. Limited edition, probably the only one still out there for resale in the area.
She is really dropping a lot of knowledge and informing me on a lot of things that I didn't know with these bags and different shoes. Guys got to step their game up. She is really coming with it. Let's move down the wall a little bit. I want to make sure I picked up one that you don't see every day. The females were going crazy when this shoe dropped, and she has it here in her store. Tell them a little bit about what that is. Let's tell them more. Give them more.
As a female reseller, it was very important to me to also feature a female shoe. This is in honor of Maya Moore, WNBA player. And this shoe I am selling at retail because I want to make sure that it gets in the hands of a female that is inspired to push past.
What size is that? Let them know what size it is, because that's heat.
This shoe is a size 7.5.
And what's the retail on that? My daughter see this. She might be down here trying to get her hands on that one.
The retail on this shoe, I believe, is like 140.
140, that's a great price for some heat, something you don't see every day. Let's go into another one for the ladies. I want to get this one on camera as well. Let them know about that one.
This is a Doran Becker. And for those of you who do know or do not know, Doran Becker, Jordan has given back so much for every shoe that is sold. There's a percentage that goes to cancer, cancer awareness, and the cancer research.
Yeah, something Jordan and Nike brand does for that hospital. I believe it's up there near Oregon too, near the campus. Let's get into a little bit of some of your foam posits. You have several colors up here. What's the market on some of the foams now? It's kind of went down a little bit with so many colors that they dropped.
Depending on the colorway, the resale value is good. These shoes typically release for $250. Resale value can be onwards of $300, sometimes $350 to $400 for the foam posits.
Some of the more popular colors that they come with. Real nice shoe. I know everybody wears it because you really can't scuff it and tear it up too bad. You just have to worry about some of the yellowing on the sole. We had to make sure we got this shoe on camera. Something crazy out there that you don't see every day. Tell them what that one is. You got heat in your store. You got some stuff down here in Covington, Kentucky.
This is a SB. I had to make sure I added this to my collection. This is known as the Ugly Christmas Sweater. I purchased a lot of these shoes during Christmas season from, I would say, November to December. I was running looking for these shoes. Shout out to the Illis over in Cincinnati. This pair was actually purchased from Will there at the Illis to add to a display that I had to feature this shoe for the month of December.
Yeah, shout out to Will over there and all the guys at his place. Check him out on one of our episodes as well. Something else we had to get on camera for the ladies. Had to get this one on camera. I'm going to let her tell us what it is, but it's shining and sparkly. Let them know about that Jordan 3.
This Retro 3 is called the AWOC. This is a collaboration with Jordan and Vogue magazine. The editor, her name is Anna Wintour. She's known for wearing her tweed jackets. That's why the upper sole here is with tweed. And then you have the tongue with the designer leather. You have AWOC on the back, which, like I say, is symbolic for her name, Anna Wintour, which is for AWOC is okay.
I didn't. You said that. I never noticed the leather on the tongue. A little thinner Jordan 3 tongue. The tongue on the 3s is always real thick, but this leather is fire on this tongue. Dope pair of shoes, ladies. Let's get her top 5 sneakers of all time in her collection. It could be a grail as well. You don't have to exactly have it. But let's go over your top 5 all time.
My top 5 of all times would be the Bred 11, which I'm rocking.
That's money.
Would be the top 3, Retro 1, the Bred 1, He Got Game, and also the Flu Game.
You said that He Got Game. I didn't have that one. Never had it until it released, I believe. Was it last year or year before? And I still haven't brought myself to wear it because I'm such a fan of it. That's a classic shoe to have in your top 5. But we want to thank you for allowing us to come down and interview you and also promote your store. What you're doing with this Black-owned business and showing these kids in our community is something very important. And I can tell, speaking with you today, how important it is for you. Thank you for what you're doing, just period. We wanted to salute you.
My pleasure. Thank you.
We want to thank everybody for tuning in to Everyday Sneakerheads on this evening. For giving me 20 to 30 minutes of your day is truly, truly, I'm grateful and it's a blessing. Just to give you a little bit of information on what is going on out here in the sneaker community and people building and coming together for a great cause and showing the next generation on what it is. Thank you. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Johnny J's on YouTube and Everyday Sneakerheads on Facebook and Instagram. Give us your social media and where they can find you for some of these purchases on this fire that you have down here in Covington, Kentucky.
Information for 2-3 Sneaker Lounge on Facebook. You could find it at my name, Benita Grissom, or you could find it at 23 Sneaker Lounge official page, and also on Instagram. It is 2-3 Sneaker Lounge, 23 Sneaker Lounge on Instagram.
23 Sneaker Lounge, you heard her. Thank you all for your time. Another great episode. Salute.